Okay, so this is going to be the last video for this week, and here we are going to talk about the cash flows. What is a cash flow? A cash flow is basically a transaction from one party to another. Okay, now here we are going to define it a little different from one's perspective, and we are going to say that a cash flow is the difference between the total cash receipts and the total cash disbursements for a given period of time. And that is going to be typically 1 year in most of our examples. But as I have told you, starting from the fourth week, we are going to study different payment periods and different interest periods other than years. Okay. So a cash flow is the difference between the total cash receipts. What is a receipt? It is basically a revenue. It is an amount of money that you are going to get. Inflow. Okay? So this is an income for your accounts. And it's the difference between the cash receipts and the disbursements. So what is a disbursement? It's an outflow. It is a cost. Okay? It is an expense. So therefore, the cash flow is written in the net terms here. The difference between the total cash receipts and the total cash disbursements in a given period of time. So what does that mean? For example, in the following year, you basically calculate your total cash receipts, the total income, and you subtract your total expenses, total disbursements, total costs. Then the net amount is going to be the cash flow for that year. Okay. Now, cash flows are very important in our studies in engineering economics because they form the basis for evaluating projects, equipment, and investment alternatives. So we need to understand how to model a question with respect to cash flows. Now, we are going to use cash flow diagrams for that. So a cash flow diagram, when a question or a problem is given in qualitative terms, a cash flow diagram is an easy way to visualize that cash flows. In a cash flow diagram, individual cash flows are represented as vertical arrows along a horizontal time scale. Now, you are going to see that example in the next question, but let me show that to you for once, then I'm going to explain again this cash flow diagram when we solve this question. But you see, we have a horizontal line, okay? So over this horizontal line, we have the interest periods or the periods that is going to be mentioned in the question, okay? And over this time point, so this point is time zero, which is the current time. And this is the end of the first year. This is the end of the second year. This is the end of the third year. And this is the end of the fourth year. We have cash flows. And these cash flows are shown with the vertical arrows. Okay? Vertical arrows. As it is described here. Individual cash flows at any time point are represented as vertical arrows. Over a horizontal time scale, on the horizontal line, we have the time units. Now, the positive cash flows or the net inflows, inflow means that is being coming into the account, are represented by upward pointing arrows. They are counted as positive. And the negative cash flows, which are outflows, net outflows, are represented by downward pointing arrows. So, anything that gets out of your account is shown as a negative cash flow, which is a downward pointing arrow. If it is an income, if it is an inflow, then it is shown as an upward pointing arrow. Now, you can draw the length of these arrows. You can, when you want to draw these arrows, the length of the arrows can be proportional to the corresponding cash flow. And each cash flow is assumed to occur at the end of the respective time period. So at this point, you are going to assume this. Even if you get positive cash flows throughout a year at any time, for example, at any month or at any week, it doesn't matter. At this point, because we are going to study our analysis, perform our analysis on yearly time units, we are just going to assume that every cash flow occurs at the end of the study period, which is at the end of the year for the examples. Now, let us solve this question now and complete our course for this week, which is basically a simple question where we try to draw a cash flow diagram. A company plans to invest $100,000 to manufacture a new product. So this is the initial payment that the company needs to invest for manufacturing this new product. The sale of this product is expected to provide a net income of $35,000 a year for 4 years. So this means for the following 4 years, and it says beginning at the end of the first year, for the following 4 years, we are going to get an income of $35,000 at the end of each year. Okay. So right now we are going to invest $100,000, and for the following 4 years, in the end of each year, we are going to get $35,000 of income and net income as the expected value. Okay, so the question is basically asking us to draw the cash flow diagram with annual resolution. So annual resolution means we are going to use yearly, annual means yearly, remember, yearly time units. So how do we draw this cash flow diagram? First, we need to draw a horizontal line, as you can see here. And right now, we need to invest $100,000, and we are going to get net income for 4 years. Therefore, the total length of this horizontal line should be 4 units, and these are years. Now, the initial investment that the company needs to make is $100. For this product. Now, we are going to draw this cash flow diagram from company's perspective. So from company's perspective, that is a cost. That is a loss. So this $100,000 right now is being lost from company's perspective. It is gone. It is invested. Therefore, we have a negative cash flow here at the current time zero at the beginning. And as you can see, it's a very long arrow. $100,000 here is represented by a long downward arrow. Now, after that, in the end of each year for 4 years, we are going to get an expected net income of $35,000. Therefore, in the end, first, second, and third, and the fourth year, so these points are end of the years. If this is current time zero, this is the end of the first year, this is the end of the second year, end of the third year, and end of the fourth year. We are going to get $35,000 of net income as expectation. And these are shown with upward arrows, which are comparatively shorter than the arrow that we have drawn in the beginning. Okay. So as you can see, all cash flows are drawn vertically at the respective time points, and a negative cash flow is shown with a downward arrow, and the positive cash flows are shown with upward arrows, and the length of these arrows are proportional to the mentioned amounts here. So this is the cash flow diagram from company's perspective. In this course, when we are solving our future examples, I totally recommend you draw a cash flow diagram in order to understand the question better. Okay, always start by drawing a cash flow diagram. Okay, even though in many of the examples in this presentation files, I do not provide in cash flow diagram, I always recommend the students when they are solving a question. I always recommend students to draw a cash flow diagram, which explains the cash flows in the question in a much more clear manner, just like here. Now, when you see this picture, you are actually getting the question in a much better way. Okay, this is the end of the first week. Now, at every week, you are going to have some reading assignments, and also in every 2 weeks, approximately, you are going to solve some mandatory homework assignments, which you are going to submit in usually, but in every week when you complete your asynchronous lectures, you need to do your reading assignments, which are mentioned in the regarding week of the lecture in Blackboard platform. All right, have a nice week and see you on the next one.